teaser. This is a work of fiction. Names, characters, businesses, and places are all fake.
You reach Cole Bishop. Sorry, I'm not taking any calls for the foreseeable future. You may hate me right now, and I don't blame you. Just don't call me back.
Cole, where are you? Running off with a head full of misguided thoughts isn't gonna solve anything. Call me back, damn it. Please. We love you.
I just kinda think it's best for everyone at this point if I abandon this whole misguided universe.
She did it. She fucking did it, man.
Fiona? He broke it off months ago.
I'm not back with Fiona.
And what's wrong?
She posted on Twitter. Then her journalist friends forwarded it with their own spin, touting lies and painting me as an abuser.
Well, that may be liable for a start.
She is a journalist.
Cole, these are just comments. The judgment of others.
It's more than that. It's everywhere.
And how does that make you feel?
Doc, you know what I've been through.
Of course. You've questioned your own behavior countless times, and now she's gone and done something that's bitten right into your own insecurities.
I have nightmares about her.
How so?
Just trying to fix things I can never control and never escape. And I am the monster she makes me out to be.
It's your subconscious attacking you.
I certainly hope so.
Based on your own recollection, you did the very best that you could.
I don't even know anymore.
Cole, I'm concerned. When are you coming in?
Not anytime soon.
You off your medication?
Sorry, Doc. Talk soon.
After I first read the stories that bitch promised she'd post, watching as it blew up on socials and my perfectly adequate life began crumbling to dust, there was only one person in town I knew I could lean on. My sister, Katrina. I needed somewhere to lay low, away from eyes I imagined glaring back at me, judging me for atrocities I did not commit. Was it worth it, Kat?
What?
Any of it, really. I feel responsible.
For?
Everything. For 6 months.
Have you tried talking to her?
Fiona's chaos. It's like she's going through some kind of psychosis or something. She sent this long-ass essay to Mom the other day telling her how terrible I am.
What the hell?
Yep, I'm trying to convince her I'm a drug addict and just an all-around shit person. Mom told her to go fuck herself.
Go, Mom.
Said she'd always stand by her son.
Cause she knows it's not true.
You weren't there the whole time. Can't help feeling that some of what she's saying is true. This bullshit, too. I can't deny it all.
She's gaslighting you, Cole.
I can't.
This is KL6J5 Smooth. And we're not only your only station for smooth jazz, post-punk, and emerging ska fusion. We're also the only station in the Bay Area with inexplicably no advertising. We'll talk to Dylan next about whether the government is spying on us through those smart pass cans.
What's this?
Don't open it, just...
Why?
Save it for later.
No, Ryan, weirdo. I'm not in the mood right now. Very country kitchen. This is actually pretty cozy. Yeah, I'm not about to bake any cookies or anything. I can already see another nasty little text message clogging up the screen. Fiona sent that earlier on. I couldn't bring myself to open it or even delete the thread. I was paralyzed, responding would only fuel the fire. Pretty sure Kat left the stock photos in a couple of those frames. Looks like the last of that case Kat picked up as we were swerving away from the Napa Valley. A much coveted bottle of Amon Vineyards full-bodied Shiraz. I think it came to $3.78 a bottle. Where do you keep the glasses?
Don't worry about it. Just bring the bottle. And this rain is something else.
Tell me about it.
A dozen calls a day, despite insisting you all leave me alone. I am fine. And I'm sure my former colleague, Mike Ferrugia, can answer any and all of your questions. Leave me alone.
Cole, trust you're doing well, buddy. I know, not exactly the best of times, and I wanted to check in and see how you were doing. Full disclosure, I still have you on Find My Friends, and I've been following you for 60 miles. Please call me back. We can meet on neutral ground. Like a church or some shit. Okay, talk soon.
Thank you.
Mike Frugia, creator-director of Two Sands, my former company.
Cole Bishop, driving blindly through the desert to escape me.
Don't flatter yourself, Mike. You're the least of my worries.
Fair.
Hey! Kid! I got a whole lot of...
You duplicitous plaid shirt-wearing motherfucker.
Wow, your eyes are, like, shiny.
Rot in hell. Mike greeted me at the door. Well, that's not true. Two-faced bastard accosted me. Smiles and shallow fuckery. Tried to shake my hand, but he yanked it away. Next thing I know, this doe-eyed waitress is guiding us to a booth.
You, buddy.
Yeah.
How are you doing, anyway?
I'm fine.
Look, I need you to understand. I tried, fought for you every step of the way. Even guilt-tripped those assholes into giving you that golden handshake. You're a fucking millionaire, man. Try and see the silver lining.
Money can't buy my reputation back. I'm being hounded by Fiona's supporters on social media day in and day out. Fucking strangers who don't have a goddamn clue what actually happened.
They don't want to know you. You're a target right now.
Yeah, and Toussaint's statement only made it worse.
It's a fucking press release, man.
You, on the other hand, knew exactly what Fiona was like. All those phone calls and text messages, you saw how she affected me. Then you pulled the rug out from under me anyway.
I am sorry. Genuinely sorry. I didn't want it to turn out like this. It doesn't matter what you did or didn't do. Fiona is a master manipulator.
Mike, I understand why you're here, but please don't bother.
What do you mean?
Make all the excuses you like. You can justify anything, but I'm not gonna forgive you.
I honestly just wanted to make sure you were okay.
I'm not. Now take your guilty fucking conscience and go. I've had more than enough of your bullshit for a lifetime.
Buddy, that's not what it's...
Seriously, just go. Should just taste like sadness at this point. Mike's lucky I didn't stab him in the eye with a ketchup bottle. Is that a guitar on the fucking wall? I like the way the mood lighting makes it look like hell's asshole. Though I'm of the opinion that anything can be art, it kind of looks like a toenail monster. I cannot see the waiter and have had more than enough coffee. And what the hell is going on up there? The booths. They were surprisingly comfortable. Thank you, Mike. I'll never stop at this goddamn diner again. I can see my soul in this light. Mike thought he could debug our relationship. Only people don't work like that. In a way, it reminded me of who I was. Deep down. Just a big old nerd with more issues than the New York Times.
Back, and let me preface by saying that terminating the call does nothing for anybody.
I know.
I'd ask that you please just hold the line.
I'm sorry. I'm not good.
I can appreciate that, but I have standards. Medical standards. Just try to work with me here and I'll do what I can. Have you been doing your breathing exercises?
No, I can't say I have.
Okay, well, let's get to it. What's your major trigger right now?
A major trigger?
Yeah, a real pain point.
Certain human shit stains. He found me. We met in person.
And?
Damage control. Like every other goddamn thing he does.
Cole, I'm not saying you have to forgive him, but it does sound like he cares for your mental well-being. I've mentioned that a number of times.
Look, I know. I get it. I'm not blind that he's not evil. Shit's like that sometimes. I feel like my anger is poisoning me.
Sorry, Cole. Your world has changed. Forget social anxiety and imposter syndrome. You're embroiled in events well beyond your control.
No shit.
Quips aside, you pay me to help you. What do you need? How can I help?
Maybe you can't. Maybe you can't.
No, Cole, don't!
Thank you.
hadn't always been like this. Back in the day, Mike and I were two peas in a sweaty, unhygienic pod, living like frat boys while we each cut our teeth in our respective crafts. A few years later, after all the tantrums, setbacks, and collegial malnutrition, we were finally on the verge of something real. I miss those days.
Okay, nice little playable teaser. I wanted more. I at least wanted to kill my first zombie or something. Hope you guys enjoyed. Peace and love.